Hey now, yo, All-Star, get your game on. I'm about to kill you. Hey now, yo, All-Star, get your game on. I'm about to kill you. All that liberty roll. All these single shots. Time we killed Lesepi, whatever his name, Lupina, whatever his name is. We killed him with just a few shots to with the Ingram and two shots with the shotgun, and he died. Then somebody stuffed us with Mickey. I'm coming. I thought this happened in the second one, not the first one. I can't remember back where I started at. Dang. I just feel like the suffering. She talking about, I didn't even kill her.
Should have known it when we found you snoring next to Lupino's corpse. A comedian, huh?
The pictures were filled with good old times.
Captain Baseball Bat Boys, my favorite.
I know this part is annoying everybody. This part is annoying me too. They testing locations. They is really testing locations with this. there, yeah? Oh, for this mission I have, I'm going to kick them in the face. Oh, Rockstar. They're probably dead, probably not making games no more. But, oh, put this stupid mission in here, it's stupid. This is really testing my patience. This stupid controller. No, it's hurting my ears. It's hurting my ears too. Babies do not cry like that. I don't know what type of baby cry like that, but no baby I know cry like that. Max Payne, you put yourself in this ridiculous. You should never been a police officer. Should have been a detective. I mean, not a detective, you should have been like somebody not working with the police or the feds. Because your family would have never died if you were talking with the feds. To see how I beat this part of no. I'm gonna call him before I watch this right quick.
Excuse me, niggas.
What is Pops doing?
I said, what's up, niggas?
Yo, what'd you say?
No.
Hold
I'm
on. So sorry.
Dude, no, Pops, stop. Okay, first of all, I wet a nigga up in the six. I ain't giving no fucks, cause I took that nigga's bitch, yeah. Run up on a nigga, leave him wet like some tissue. I took that nigga's jacket, put some ice on my wrist. Yo, bitch, supposed to got genital infections. I don't really give a fuck, it's like... Oh, Mordecai, call the cops.
So, let's give this one.
No, 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 please, God, no.
Thank you.
shoot them full of holes, blow them to bits, vaporize them, disintegrate them. No matter what you do, they'll still be back, good as new.
Did this dude say vaporize them? I think he meant vape, but he said vaporize.
Michelle's diary lay on the table.
Max, no, please, Max. Why? I didn't mean to. I'm sorry.
Murderer! You killed her!
Nothing like that ever happens in the real world.
I woke up in a bad dream. My head felt two sizes too small for my brain.
Max Payne, I envy your name.
And the killer was smiling.
Pleased to meet you. I'm Frankie the Bat Niagara.
Niagara, as in you cry a lot? He had a baseball bat and I was tied to a chair. Pissing him off was the smart thing to do.
Nothing wrong with a little laugh now and then. Take me, for example. I love to watch cartoons. Cartoon violence is a fascinating thing. Let's take a break. I need to take a leak and maybe grab a cold one at the bar. Don't worry. I'll be back to finish this off. And then, it's checkout time.
You play, you pay, you bastard. He swaggered out, and the door clanged shut behind him, locks clicking into place. Everyone makes mistakes. Mine hadn't been to crack jokes about the goon with the bat. He'd have cracked my skull regardless. It hadn't even been to trust a girl with a gun. I had blindly gone after the first bad guy on my hit list when I should have been aiming further up the ladder, at the head of the Punchinello family. I couldn't bring myself to be pissed at Mona. Guess I had a soft spot for a pretty face. But when somebody decides to play baseball with your head, you tend to get sore. They had dragged me back to the basement of Lupino's hotel. I was beaten, bruised, and blue. I felt like the chair I had broken to get free. All I had was Niagara's bat, sticky with my own blood. Without a gun, I'd be no match for Frankie's men. I'd have to play hide and seek with them. Was Niagara's bat, sticky with my own blood. Without a gun, I'd be no match for Frankie's men. I'd have to play hide and seek with them.
Frankie's turf. We'll take care of it.
Yeah, I know. You said I wouldn't mind having a go at him.
It's Frankie's turf.
Yeah, I know. I know that.
Yeah, this is about to be the hardest mission in my life. Supposed to be hide and seek if I can.
All I had was Niagara's bat, sticky with my own blood. Without a gun, I'd be no match for Frankie's men. I'd have to play hide and seek with them. Without a gun, I'd be no match for Frankie's men. I'd have to play hide and seek with them.
These cutscenes would hurry up. You could just skip
all I had was Niagara's bat, sticky with my own blood.
But you could just skip
without a gun, I'd be no match for Frankie's men. I'd have to play hide and seek with them.
I wish you could just skip the cutscenes. So hard to get to this dang old chapter. He shouldn't have got his
all I had was Niagara's bat, sticky with my own blood. Without a gun, I'd be no match for Frankie's men. I'd have to play hide and seek with them.
How you let a girl woof you? That's not a Bill Cosby job. Hey now, yo, All-Star, get your game on. I'm about to kill you. Hey now, yo, All-Star, get your game on. I'm about to kill you. All that liberty roll. All these things in the shots. We do the you don't stop coming, then you won't stop coming. If you don't stop coming, then he won't stop coming. So much to do, so much to think, so much things to the rest side. Hey now, you're an all-star. Get your game on. Go play. Hey now, you're an all-star. Go play. All that liver and roll. On these human stars, you get booty hole.
Newspaper caption for a murder scene. Frankie had left his calling card, a Captain Baseball Bat Boy strip, next to a sewer passage filled with bodies.
You'd better not mess with Captain Baseball Bat Boy. Even my archenemy, Bicycle Helmet Girl, swoons at the sight of me. Aha!
There were enough corpses to put a mass murderer to shame.
I only see one corpse. Shoot at the thing in the back. Hey now, you're an all-star. Get your game on. I'm dead. Hey now. Stop. Right down the road.
Things were fast going from bad to worse.
You're going in a dead scene.
The men in blue had come and gone. They had decorated the place with chalk outlines and tied it together with yellow tape. The cops who had stayed behind were dead. Frankie, his boys, and I had the place all for ourselves.
Let's play until we die.
Just forget about it. Just forget about it. Hey, just forget about it.
Just forget about it.
That crazy witch, you should have heard her. She was a real scream when the boys caught her trying to cap the Don. Oh, that's friggin' bad. To the trio? That's even worse than what Frankie's doing to that poor bastard downstairs. She's gonna take a long time to die.
The mobster muscle on the phone was talking about Mona. Punchinello's trio were nothing but bad news.
We're all bad news.
More evidence that Punchinello didn't like me much.
I gotta clear that this over.
The fact remains that all the victims so far identified in the Ragnarok shooting have been known criminals, many of whom had large doses of V in their blood. Reliable sources say that Max Payne was also among those killed, although no body has been recovered at this time.
Reliable sources. That meant somebody thought the Mafia had me, didn't want the cops snooping around anymore. Body would be delivered to them barely recognizable. Case closed. Don Punchinello had the power to be that reliable source, which was no news, but his news was old news. Framing me hadn't been enough. Don Punchinello had put a hit on me. He wanted me dead, and it had been important enough for him to give written instructions to Frankie about it.
Max Payne should die like a dog for the trouble he's caused. Frankie, I know I can trust you to give this matter the dedication it needs.
The hotel bar was fast developing quite a history. True to his words, Frankie was there, having a beer.
Jesus Christ. How the hell did you get loose?
Got bored waiting. Thought, what the hell, we could just as well finish this here.
Fine by me. This works out just as well.
Like this, nigga.
As soon as I left the hotel, a big black Mercedes. I'd seen the car before. That time it had heralded impressive explosions. Vladimir was back,
Bang. You're dead, Max Payne.
I might have laughed if I remembered how. What's this supposed to be? Cops and robbers? Look, you want something with me? Get in line.
Peace, man. Relax. You know you are a real news item. Armed and dangerous. I am going to make you an offer you can't refuse. I've always wanted to say that.
It's a bum rap. I've been framed.
Well, that's a moot point. Whatever you did or did not do, I'm sure you had good reason for doing it. Want to hear me out?
I'm listening.
Losing Muslim with the Russians.
Punchinello messing with V is bad for business all around. But that's not all. There is this guy, Boris Dine, used to pull jobs for me. He's the captain of the cargo ship Charon. Now the bastard turncoat has gone over to the other side, Punchinello's. The ship's loaded with high-res hardware, guns, my business. If Punchinello gets hold of that cargo, he's won and I have lost. And you'll have your work cut out for you. If you want to get to Punchinello, you need heavy-duty persuaders. I am just the man to get them for you. Change the ship back under my flag, maybe pop two in the traitor Dime's head while you're at it. You'll get enough guns to start the apocalypse. You in or out?
Let's get this show on the road. Vladimir was one of those old-time bad guys with honor and morals, which made him almost one of the good guys. None of us was a saint. The Brooklyn riverfront was a maze of rusty containers, sharp-boned cranes looming up from the snowstorm. On a night like this, you couldn't help but think of the dark army of dead men sleeping with the fishes, cement shoes in line. No Minotaur lurked in this labyrinth, but somewhere out there, on the clanking deck of his cargo freighter, the skipper of the Charon was waiting, like the ferryman of the River Styx.
I just wanted to remind it right now. We're just messing with Vladimir. Vladimir is the, how can I put it, the biggest man with the most guns. And we have to learn from Vladimir. Ciao.